Good afternoon. Last session we have seen various aspects of acute alcohol poisoning, that is acute ethanol poisoning. The remaining part of alcohol poisoning, that is chronic exposure of the poison, that is called as alcoholism or alcohol abuse or alcohol dependence. As per the definition, alcoholism is a disorder characterized by excessive drinking that results in injury to person's health or inadequate social functioning or both. It is also classified by DSM-4, which defines alcoholism as a repeated alcohol-related difficulties in at least 3 of the following 7 areas of functioning. That is, tolerance, withdrawal, taking larger amount of alcohol over longer period than intended, inability to control use, means repeated use of that liquor, and there is no control, and there is urge for taking that compound. Fifth is spending greater deal of time associated with alcohol use. Giving up important activities to drink means priority is given to that particular substance, and continue use of alcohol despite physical or psychological consequences. In spite of having disease related to alcohol, they try to take that particular thing. That is also indicative of alcohol abuse or alcohol dependence. This is as per DSM-4. The various aspects of chronic alcohol use, each and every organ is affected by alcohol. Few of which is of important of your theories we are going to discuss over here. That is various fetal effects. Fetal effects of alcohol means a pregnant lady consume alcohol, that will affect the fetus. The alcohol crosses the placenta barrier and reaches up to the fetus and leads to the various congenital anomalies. The fetal abnormality may range from selected fetal alcohol effect to full-blown fetal alcohol syndrome. The fetal alcohol syndrome are classified as a facial dysmorphology, prenatal and antenatal growth deficiency, or could be CNS involvement of the fetus, including mental retardation. And similarly, stillbirth and spontaneous abortion are common those pregnant ladies who are consuming alcohol. Due to withdrawal, sudden withdrawal of this substance, or sudden cessation of alcohol by such persons, those who are dependent or involved in alcohol abuse, they results in withdrawal reaction. The withdrawal reaction may manifest as in the gradual manner as a abstinence syndrome, which is developed between 6 to 8 hours after cessation of alcohol, and characterized by tremors, agitations, sweating, nausea, headache, insomnia, abdominal pain, etc. Within 24 hours to 36 hours after cessation of alcohol, there are chances of alcohol hallucinations. Between 7 to 48 hours, there is chances of seizures, also called as a rum fits. The seizures are chronic tonic in nature, with or without loss of consciousness. There is chance of alcohol ketoacidosis, delirium tremens, and Wernicke's and Korsakoff's syndrome. The few which we are discussing over here, that is delirium tremens. This particular disorder is an acute episode of delirium due to alcohol withdrawal. This is acute condition which is generally seen in 3 to 5 days after cessation of alcohol, and it is sudden in onset. It is first described by Pearson in 1813. The disorder is characterized by delirium, that is clouding of consciousness, disorientation with loss of recent memory, in amnesia, anterograde amnesia. The disorder may be associated with vivid hallucination, mostly visual or sometimes auditory in nature. There is agitation, restlessness, tremors, ataxia, insomnia. Various autonomic disturbances are common, like sweating, fever, rising temperature, tachycardia, hypertension, dilated pupils. These are the autonomic disturbances which are produced. When person is suffering from this condition, that is delirium tremens, he is not held responsible for any act, because he is considered to be of suffering from unsoundness of mind. Next is Korsakoff syndrome, which is this particular syndrome which is seen in alcoholic withdrawal, and it is first described by Russian neuropsychiatrist Sergei Korsakoff. It is a late neuropsychiatric manifestation of Wernicke's encephalopathy. It is an alcoholic induced, characterized by alcohol induced persistent amnestic disorder, and occur due to thiamine deficiency. This Korsakoff syndrome persists, characterized by these three manifestations, that is amnesia, confabulation, and polyneuropathy. These are the manifestations which is occurring due to thiamine deficiency in the case of chronic alcoholism. That is the reason whenever we see the patient of alcohol intoxication, prior to giving dextrose, we first give the thiamine, which is characterized by amnesia, confabulation, and polyneuropathy. This profound anterograde, there is a profound anterograde amnesia, means anterograde amnesia means inability to learn new things, and followed by a milder retrograde amnesia, means a person is not able to recall the things or remember the things. Means there is profound amnesia for anterograde things, followed by milder form of retrograde amnesia. There is impairment in means confabulation, means there is impairment in visual spatial abstract and conceptual reasoning. Most of the patients who are demonstrate an acute onset of Korsakoff syndrome in associated with Wernicke syndrome, where is rest person shows gradual onset. These are the few things of medical importances in case of chronic alcoholism or chronic ethanol poisoning. Now, methanol poisoning, it is a pure methanol, is a pure methanol, is a wood alcohol, or methanol is a colorless volatile liquid with an odor similar to ethyl alcohol and has a burning taste. It is normally present in certain, this substance is normally present in certain homemade beverages, antifreeze or paint removers, dyes, resins, or adhesives and varnishes. Most of these cases are accidental in nature, In mass death, there is intentional mixing, adulteration of methanol with ethanol. This is referred to as a liquor tragedies, which form the forensic significance. Methanol or methyl alcohol is metabolized in liver. This is the metabolism of methyl alcohol in liver. It is metabolized in liver. In the first step of degradation, methanol is transformed to formaldehyde by the enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase. This reaction is slower than the next step, means formation or degradation of methanol to formaldehyde is slower to the formation of formic acid. First step after degradation in liver, alcohol methanol is degraded into formaldehyde with the help of enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase. This reaction is slower than next step. What is the next step? The formation of formaldehyde to formic acid with the help of enzyme aldehyde dehydrogenase. This may explain the reason for the latency of the symptoms between ingestion and effect. There is a latent duration of the occurrence of the manifestation after the ingestion of this substance. The half-life of formaldehyde is estimated to be around 1 to 2 minutes, and these two substances, formaldehyde and formic acid, are the toxic one. The formaldehyde is 33% more toxic than methanol, and formic acid is 6 times more toxic than methanol. But the reaction time and the degradation of these substances are different. Formaldehyde require more time as compared to formic acid, and they are responsible for retinal toxicity and metabolic acidosis. These are the two things which is occurring in cases of methanol poisoning, and the rate of oxidation is around 1/5 of the ethanol, and repeated small doses will accumulate. This is cumulative poison. Repeated small doses of methanol accumulate in the body, and after stressful condition they release and causing the various toxic effects. The various clinical manifestation of methanol poisoning: there is a latent period, means after consumption of this poison, the latent period is around 12 to 24 hours. This is due to the conversion. The latent period may be longer if it is with the alcohol, is a co-ingested, or shorter if the volume of methanol is larger, because they are competitive for the receptors to act. If it is adulterated with ethanol, then the severity of the manifestation will be a slower one. If the volume of methanol is more as compared to the ethanol, the duration of the latent period will be shorter one. The earliest manifestation after consumption due to any irritating substance manifests like nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and severe cramp, followed by the manifestation of pancreatitis. The characteristic clinical manifestation with the methanol poisoning is the ocular toxicity. The most characteristic symptom related to vision: there is a blurred, misty, or dimmed vision, like a snowstorm vision or snowfield vision. There is constricted visual field, photophobia, nystagmus, and decreased light perception. And there is black spots in the visual fields due to central and peripheral scotoma. There is chance of complete blindness due to formic acid, which is inhibited the cytochrome oxidase in optic nerve and causes optic neuritis and optic atrophy. On ocular examination, pupillary will be dilated and loss of pupillary reaction. On fundoscopic examination, there is hyperemia of optic disc and retinal edema. This is the ocular manifestation of methanol poisoning. There is CNS manifestation which is mimic like a meningismus, which is characterized by dizziness, vertigo, headache and stiffness of neck. That is to be differentiated between meningitis, and pupil will be dilated and fixed at a later stage. There is sometimes convulsion and followed by coma. There is associated with metabolic acidosis due to the high iron gap which is caused by the formic acid. There is respiratory depression and blood pH will be less than 7, which is indicative of poor prognosis. Means blood pH is acidic in nature. Even patient is recovered, the most common sequelae, permanent sequelae in case of survival is blindness, followed by extrapyramidal movement disorder like Parkinsonism-like syndrome due to the putamen damage, or toxic encephalopathy or neuropathy. These are the permanent sequelae in patients who are recovered by these poisons. The diagnosis is having high iron gap, fundoscopic examination showing the fundus with hyperemia of optic disc with retinal edema, smell and blood methanol level which is more than 50 mg per 100 ml indicated severe poisoning. In the treatment of methanol poisoning, stomach with 500 ml of sodium bicarbonate should be done and some quantity should be left in the stomach. Emesis is not recommended because of potential CNS depression. Activated charcoal not having of much use because of limited absorption of methyl alcohol, and a specific antidote is ethanol for the methanol poisoning because of the competitiveness of this substance. It competes with this ethanol competes with methyl alcohol for ADH, as described in step 1 for the conversion of the methanol degradation is only by the alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme. Then ethanol, it competes with methyl for ADH and prevents conversion of methanol to more toxic formaldehyde. Ethanol is excreted unchained in the urine. The route of administration is the substance of ethanol, which is given as an antidote, which is 10% ethanol in 10 ml, 10% at dose of 10 ml per kg IV over 30 minutes, then 1.5 ml per kg per hour to maintain ethanol level around 100 mg per deciliter. Then we have to correct the acidosis by giving the sodium bicarbonate IV 500 to 700 ml or 7.5% solution slow IV infusion, followed by folinic acid IV 1 to 2 mg per kilogram 6 hours, and hemodialysis if the cases are not responding, then hemodialysis. Postmortem features, there is profound cyanosis, lung will be congested, edemasis, gastric mucosa or mucosal membrane of GI tract is congested, inflamed, shows hemorrhages. There is early necrosis of liver, and various toxic effect which is seen in kidneys. There is retinal edema, and the diagnostic technique is assessment of methyl alcohol in gastric and blood by chemical analysis. So this is something which is related with methyl alcohol poisoning. Now next substance which is of causing the CNS depression is barbiturate. Barbiturate is the derivative of barbituric acid discovered by Adolf von Baer in 1864. It is used commonly for as a sedative hypnotics, preoperative sedation and treatment for the seizure disorders. The barbiturate is a CNS depressant. They depress neuronal activity in midbrain reticular formation, and they increase chloride channel potency with neuron. They facilitate and prolong the inhibitory effect of GABA and glycine, which increases chloride channel potency with neuron. The barbiturate are classified according to their action into the ultra short acting, intermediate acting, and long acting. Barbiturate are rapidly absorbed from GIT, including the rectum. It is also absorbed through the subcutaneous route or intravenous infusion or IV route. After ingestion, barbiturate are preferentially absorbed from the small intestine. They are concentrated in the liver for the shorter duration and evenly distributed in body fluid. Longer acting barbiturate tends to be more lipid soluble and more protein bound and more rapid and shorter duration of action and are metabolized almost completely in the liver. During metabolism of the most of drug, they are converted into alcohol, ketones and phenols, which are excreted in the urine as such or in the form of glucuronic acid conjugates. The metabolism is more rapid in children and slower in elderly persons. The various clinical manifestation or the toxic effect of these substances, as they are CNS depressant, they produce drowsiness, ataxia, confusion, delirium, excitement, hallucinations, headache, lateral and vertical nystagmus, paresthesia, and visual disturbances. There is temporary failure of accommodation leading to the diplopia, may occur in during recovery also. That is the thing which makes it drug abuse. There is psychological and physical dependence by these substances. The pupils are first constricted but later dilated. This stage of confusion is responsible for the drug automatism means person consume a drug by which he is not able to remember whether he has taken or not. Because of this confusion, he or she is go on taking the drug. That is the reason which causes the poisoning, accidental poisoning by this substance. Means person is unable to recall whether the medicine has been taken due to this confusional state. This particular condition is called as a automatism. Means person is unable to remember and go on taking, which causing the accidental poisoning. Pupils are first constricted, then dilated, then hypothermia, followed by a characteristic feature of formation of cutaneous bullae or blebs. This is characteristic manifestation, or it is also called as a barb burns or barbiturate blisters or friction blisters or coma blisters, seen most commonly in cases of barbiturate. But in almost any other condition which produce coma, they can be produced, like due to the consumption of hydrocodone, methadone, imperamine or tricyclic valproic acid. These are the drugs which can cause the comatose condition in which this type of bullae or blebs can be formed over the body. This is called as a barb burn. The frequency is around 6 to 10% in cases, those who are in comatose condition. And the most common site of formation of this barb burn, where the friction or pressure naturally occurs, means the site of interdigital cleft, buttocks, back of thighs, calves and forearms, inner aspect of knees, ankles. In the site where having the more friction, there is chances of production of these blebs to be formed. They are characterized by, these blebs are characterized by tense epidermal blisters which develop within 48 to 72 hours of onset of unconsciousness, and they are self-limiting lesions. Heal spontaneously in 1 to 2 weeks. The inflammation usually absent or very minimal and contain clear serous fluid. That could be a hemorrhagic, depend upon the how much friction is there. Then it can be mimic like a blebs or burn. The mechanism which documented in various books, it could be due to the external uninterrupted pressure and arterial hypotension due to shock, which leads to the hypoxia and local ischemia. And metabolically, most active cells are affected earliest. And sweet gland necrosis is there, which forming the necrotic bullet. Or could be due to direct toxic action on the epidermis, due to immune mechanism. These are the few hypotheses has been mentioned by various authors. The usual fatal dose of barbiturate is for the longer acting, that is 10 mg per 100 ml, intermediate acting is 7 mg per 100 ml and shorter acting is 3 mg per 100 ml. The diagnosis can be made by thin layer chromatography, so urine, stomach content or serum residuals, or gas chromatography for detecting phenobarbital in hairs, or semi-quantitative and qualitative imid homogeneous enzyme immune assay for measurement of class of barbiturate in urine and in serum or plasma. EEG, there is a alpha coma, means the alpha wave, alpha, beta, these waves are seen in EEG pattern. These alpha waves are seen if the patient is conscious. If the patient is unconscious and unconscious due to barbiturate, in that condition this alpha wave will appear. That is the poor prognosis, sign of poor prognosis of barbiturate poisoning. Presence of alpha coma in comatose patient as a result of barbiturate indicative of poor prognosis. For the management of the patient, we have to monitor complete blood count, serum electrolyte, glucose, blood urea, nitrogen, creatinine, urine myoglobin. These are the general investigation we have to perform and monitor whether they are increasing or decreasing in nature. Then we have to give the gastric lavage activated charcoal emetic agent are contraindicated as they are CNS depressant. There is no any specific antidote. Force alkaline diuresis to be performed. Hemodialysis or hemoperfusion is effective and supportive therapy in the form of giving oxygen, intubation and assist ventilation. We have to cut the hypotension by giving the 10 to 20 ml per kilogram of isotonic IV fluids and giving the permission position of the person or some dopamine and non-adrenaline drugs. The postmortem features are in the form of peripheral cyanosis, froth at the mouth and nose, barbiturate blister, which could be in case of tricyclic, carbon monoxide, morphabed and methacholine intoxication, intensely congested lung, and congestion or even erosion of the stomach. The confirmatory diagnosis is only after the chemical analysis or isolation of the substance by thin layer chromatography or gas chromatography or semi-quantitative IMC methods. This particular or popular drug is agent for suicide. The various famous people who commit suicide with overdoses of barbiturate include Caesarea Pavese, who is the Italian author, or Marilyn Monroe, who was the American actress. They have used this particular substance for the suicide purpose. This particular substance, barbiturate, a popular drug for euthanasia. In Switzerland, it is used for used by the exit association. Utilizes oral phenobarbital for this purpose. There is chance of accidental exposure due to the barbiturate automatism. As I already told you, in a confusional state, person go on taking without remembering the things, these tablets, which causing the poisoning, which is called as a barbiturate automatism. It is a drug of abuse and recreation use by the various person. Popular drug of abuse because of psychological symptom it produces. Shorter acting and intermediate acting are preferred to take as a drug abuse. It is the use in judicial execution by giving the injection as a sequential drug combination of sodium thiopental, penicillin bromide and potassium chloride is used for giving the lethal injection. This injection therapy for capital punishment given in America, USA, for that purpose. It is also used as a tooth serum for the purpose of narcoanalysis. The next substance is chlorohydrate. The chlorohydrate was first synthesized in 1831 by Justin von Liebig. Justice von Liebig is first used as a sedative and hypnotics in 1869. It is nowadays rarely used as a hypnotic today. It is a common adulterant of illicited liquor to enhance an intoxicating effect. That's why it is called as a Mickey Finn and knockout drugs. The effect which is produced by this substance is dramatic effects, which is in a shorter duration. Chlorohydrate is a colorless crystalline substance with a pungent clear like odor and bitter in taste. Chlorohydrate is metabolized by hepatic alcohol dehydrogenase into trichloroethanol, and its first active metabolite is lipid soluble, having high affinity for neurons. It is responsible for chlorhydrate hypnotic effect. It conjugates with chlorpromic acid and excreted in urine as a urochloric acid. Approximately 15 to 30% of those excreted in urine within 24 hours as a glucuronic and about glucuronide and about 5% as a free trichloroethanol. The clinical manifestation of this poison, there is always nausea, vomiting, retrosternal burning, hemorrhagic gastritis, or rarely gastric and intestinal perforation or esophagitis with stricture formation in the seen. The peculiar pear-like odor of chlorhydrate may help to distinguish it from the other sedatives. Hence, from the mouth or breath of the person, there is a peculiar breath smell of pear-like odor, which is responsible or which is helping the physician to be differentiated from other causes of the unconsciousness or condition. People may be myotic initially, then dilated as stage of coma develops. There is ataxia, lethargy and deep coma within 1 to 2 hours. It is very short duration and traumatic effect over the person. That's why it is used by the robbers also or day trade. There is characteristic manifestation or the manifestation of the condition which can cause death is the CVS in the form of arterial fibrillation, supraventricular tachycardia, ventricular tachycardia, multifocal premature ventricular contraction, ventricular fibrillation. These are the things which is to be controlled to save the patient, and arrhythmia is the generally cause of death in case of chlorhydrate cases. The combination of deep coma and dysarrhythmia in a patient who is not hypoxic is typical for the chlorhydrate poisoning. Means deep coma associated with dysarrhythmia and there is no any sign of hypoxic effects is the clinical combination to diagnose a case of chlorhydrate intoxication. There is a dysfunctional of liver which leads to the jaundice. Albuminuria means there is chance of renal and hepatic damage and non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema. In the management, we have to look for and monitor the ECG, pulse oximetry, arterial blood gas analysis. Emesis is not recommended. Lavage should be careful with flexible. It's with flexible tubes, and cardiac arrhythmia should be managed with the beta blockers. There is no any specific antidote for this condition, but flumazenil 200 microgram by infusion followed by 100 microgram at a 1 minute interval up to 3 times, total 400 microgram is documented by a few authors. If the person is not responding for this thing and there is clear renal and hepatic involvement to remove the toxic substances, one can perform hemodialysis and hemoperfusion. For hypotension, we have to give 10 to 20 ml per kilogram of isotonic IV fluid. Positioning and cardiogenic drug, that is dopamine and noradrenaline, to increase the blood pressure. This particular substance, chlorhydrate, is used for rape and robbery. Chlorhydrate is soluble in both water and alcohol. A solution of chlorhydrate in alcohol called as a knockout drop and make you faint. It renders a person helpless immediately. Because of its shorter duration of action and profound action for duration, it is used for the robbery or rape. It renders a person helpless with immediate effect, used for robbery and death trap. It is also referred to as a dry wine. It's called as a dry wine. So these are the few substances of medical legal importance and few aspects which causing the CNS depression.
Thank you. Okay.